Please stop crying, Maisie. You don't mind if I call you Maisie, or is it Maisie? Sitting aside from the desk in her neat office, the sign read, Bridget Hamilton, Youth Mental Health Counselor. There was nothing between them now but a yard of carpet, although the mother's confidence had already dipped.
No, that's okay. It's with a silent Y. My dad's got a Y. He's called Harry.
Harry?
Barry.
Do you have a concern for the welfare of a family member? Bridget asked. Only, that's usually why parents come to me. Stifling sobs, voice quivering, Maisie with a Y nodded.
Yes, I think it's time to talk about Frankie.
Your son? Bridget nodded, waiting for the waterworks to evaporate. She stared through the pot plant, the counsellor, the desk, everything as her mind hit the wall.
He's not like the other boys. He's not like our family. He's different.
Tell me. I can help provide guidance. Special educational needs are considered very seriously here.
He doesn't play with his cousins down at the breaker's yard no more. He says lessons are slow, so he daydreams. And he doesn't like time in the playground neither. Forgets to go to lunch with the others because he's writing things or drawing lines and counting. He's always adding stuff up.
Bridget realised this could be an easy one. Socialisation skills can improve rapidly if your child is introduced into welcoming situations with others, built around things he already likes doing.
He doesn't like motorbikes or hanging around with other kids at the bus stop. He wants to play alone, see? It isn't even play when you look at what he does, staring at the sky and stuff. He fills little books with crabby little notes. Some of it's written back to front.
Bridget tried again. It could be dissociation or a protective mechanism, like a dyslexia workaround. Perhaps just an unusually active imagination.
I wanted to know what he was staring at, and he said he was measuring stars. I said he should stop wasting his time and go sit with his dad by the telly, get some chips inside him. There was game shows and footy on, but I can't get him to stay still 5 minutes.
Have you heard of attention deficit disorder?
I think it's more, you know, something wrong with his thing, Frankie's leanings. We don't want anything like that in our house. There ain't any history of that. We ain't got no foreign monkey blood, so he didn't catch any of that from us.
I should advise you that orientation is not a genetic characteristic or a virus.
It ain't that. The maths teacher gives him more homework than the other kids.
You suspect discrimination?
What are we going to do? There's no compensation neither. It's shameful.
Can you describe the behaviours which first made you think there was a problem? Maisie shuffled, trying to remember.
Frankie came home one day.
Yes?
He'd got himself a library card.
A library card? At last, evidence.
He wanted shelves for his birthday. Shelves, I ask you? Then he said all people are born equal and only tangible difference is what you do. I said he should shut his mouth because he has no respect for his dad, and he says he respects people who have earned respect, and if he respects the ones who haven't, it devalues the currency. My poor boy, he started using deodorant and using weird words like lumminess.
Luminescent? Bridget sat back decisively. Yes, I think I know what's the matter with your son. As you suspected, he isn't like your family. He won't fit in. And he will leave you and go on to do things which you will struggle to understand. I'm very sorry, Maisie, and I know it will come as quite a shock to a mother.
Please, tell me, what's the matter with him? What has my boy got?
He's intelligent.